Good morning. I didn't actually make a PowerPoint presentation, but I'll just summarize what my thoughts are. It was nice to come here because I've realized how differently I think from everybody else. Everybody spoke about things they were inspired by during work. My inspiration actually came from things I do outside work, which is hiking, trekking, etc. So we know that global warming and climate change are all real problems. You know, there's enough scientific evidence to prove that they are, even though Donald Trump considers it a hoax and a fake news. But most scientists think that what we do in the next decade will determine the future of our planet. And there's a fairly famous environmentalist who once made a statement that the greatest threat to our planet is the belief that someone else will save it. And therefore, I thought that over the next decade, we as an ophthalmic society should maybe try and contribute to helping the planet in small and simple ways. The biggest problem, I think, that we do is the amount of waste we generate. The plastic waste generated in our OR is probably higher than, you know, most other workplaces. We should try and do something about that. The standard dictum for waste management anywhere is reduce, reuse, and recycle. And I wanted to add another one to that, which was regulate. So reduce is simple. Only open those instruments that you absolutely require on your table. In fact, my boss in Canada even used to reuse his keratome to make his sideboard. He says it's great, you just make a small entry. The inner lip of the wound is actually much smaller. The outer one on the external surface near the epithelium is larger. And those sideboards actually require quite a lot of manipulation. So there's no need to open a separate instrument. The reuse is very important, and it can be done in two ways. One is reusing apparently single-use instruments. The Arvind Group has shown in a very good program and study about life cycle assessment how you can flash sterilize, reuse the same tubings, and not increase your incidence of endophthalmitis. And that's a really well-written article of this. And the other maybe long-term solution to this would be to work with industry and revert back to reusable instruments and diamond blades. This will take some time, but in the long run, it's probably a wise suggestion. Recycling plastic, again, is very important. And the last thing I wrote about is regulate, which is to work with regulatory bodies to change the ophthalmic surgery guidelines, which are currently just based on extrapolation from general surgical data. So the AIOS has already done this, and in their guidelines, they have said you don't need to change your surgical gown for every case. You can do it for every 5 cases. But more of these green practices of reusing instruments and tubings should be acceptable by them, endorsed by them, for our regulatory bodies like the NABH to accept them. And that will also improve the chance that ophthalmic practitioners will incorporate those. Because the biggest fear these days is if your patient develops endophthalmitis, it will be a sort of a legal issue, and then these factors will be considered in what the outcome of that will be. But if these green practices are endorsed by our regulatory bodies, people are more likely to accept them. I'd just like to end here. There's a famous saying, we do not inherit the earth from our ancestors, we borrow it from our children. I do hope that my children, who are very small now, but get to enjoy the same beauty that I have and not be stuck with famine and other sort of problems in the earth.